First of all, I offer my respectful obeisances to His Divine Grace Nityananda Prabhishtha Guru Padupat Master of Sarvasura Bhakti of Vishnu Maharaja and Nityananda Prabhishtha Vishnu Padupat Sarvasura Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaja Prabhupada.
Hariol, Gopra Prabhadandi.
All our Guru Vargas and our Grand Guru Deva Nityananda Prabhishtha Sarvasura Bhakti Siddhanta Sarvasura Prabhupada, all our Acharyas, who blessed us to understand our soul, nature of the soul, and the value of our human life, and Srimad Bhagavatam, basic literature, and by the mercy of our best in our international family, most of our dear friends, respected, I offer my obeisances to Srila Bhakti Aloka Paramadita Mosai Maharaj. I am happy and who has open university, no, open air university. He is always, everything is unlimited and open our consciousness. In our wisdom vijayam also, who brought everyone to this World Wisdom Association to sit together, discuss and share each other, which is also great in practical way in our wisdom society. I respect and love all our wisdom, and wisdom is many countries. They joined here. I never expect that I will be here. I think, I heard of Maharaj told me before when we were in Mayapur, and after I came to know first week of this month will be finished, but after the Alicante we were together also in temple there. I think it was completed. Just I was coming, like every year. When I came to Europe, I was keeping in this violin in my itinerary. It was great to meet with the devotees who are actually the flame of the spirit of devotion. Because in Bhagavatam told, worshipping deities, Krishna, Kapila, Lord Kapila told, and the 11th canto Krishna also told, who are worshipping my deities, but not to respecting and worshipping to my devotees, or other living creatures, human. They are just pouring ghee on the ashes. Means they never get any reaction, they never get any result. If they pour ashes, the ghee in the ashes, not in flame, not in fire, then they cannot get the benefit. Same, he told this. So we are mostly engaged with worshipping deities, but same we also worship to living deities, where Krishna is present doing this. So by the mercy of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu and Radha Govinda, you are here, this divine couple in Goloka Vrindavan, in the spiritual world, who are always Nitya Lila, their eternal pastimes going on. And both them, they combine to Gaurangas form and distributed this prema to whole world. What in Vedic knowledge coming by our disciple succession, It was very restricted before. They never come out from India, and among India, Brahminical qualities who have, only they preserve this. To study Veda and practice, it was very austere. So it was not able to everyone to practice. Because they brahmacharis, they stay in Gurukul and they study the Vedas. Vedas study means the how they utter these Vedic mantras and how to meditate to demigods and the deities, they who are maintaining this. It was very austere. So everyone have no qualification to study or to practice, and gradually it was also changed. And in the time of this Kali Yuga, it is completely changed. The system of Varnasrama, in the beginning of the creation in Kruta Yuga, first Satya Yuga, there was no Varnasrama. Only one name was Hansa. And there, everyone, after take birth, they realize their soul. They have no attraction for sense gratification. They are satisfied with their soul. Naturally, fruits or anything, they little they eat, then they have no sense attraction, and mind was not agitated by this sense gratification. So they live peacefully, and from birth they meditate with their soul to super soul. So they were all different time was there. Skrute cha dhyayati Vishnu. They always with the super soul, by their soul, they meditate. And pure sattva goodness nature was there. Mind was quiet. All have knowledge. And senses are very peaceful. That time, different time. Then after change the time, when Tritaya Yuga came, then the passionate nature dominated. Then differences came. So society disturbed. Then Krishna came and he established four Varna, four Ashram divisions, Brahman and Kshatriya, Vaishya, Sudra, according their quality, their character, he divided. And in Dwapara, again, little degraded, so started war. Kshatriyas, they dominated Brahmins, then Parshuram came, he killed two Kshatriyas. Again, Ramachandra came, he established a Kshatriyas, how to protect the society. Then, in last part of Dwapara, beginning of Kali, Supreme Lord Krishna's came, Krishna came. And he understood in Kali Yuga, the system will be failed. Everyone will become Shankara, mixed. So there will be no more this principle will work. So he has given his divine love. Prema avatar, Lila Purusha. So he has given his prema. And he told in Bhagavad Gita, give up everything to surrender to me. I will protect you. So last in his has given in 11th canto in Bhagavatam in Parsnam, he told to Uddhava and Arjuna. And after that also changed. Many things changed. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and he distributed to whole universe. He embraced to everyone without distinction of any religion, any gender, any part of any condition. He distributed this divine will and divine love, and he taught, even if we see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes, he was teaching Sanskrit to students. Then he told you, stop this. Stop this study. You start kirtan. Do kirtan. Glorify to Krishna. Understand Krishna. He sent it to Nityananda Prabhu and Haridas Thakur. He told to go to every house. They are not ordinary person. They are Nityananda Prabhu himself, Sankarsana, Anantadeva, Balarama, Lakhon, Haridas Thakur, as Brahma and Prahlada. So he sent to every house and that time, except to Odisha, all country was ruled by Muslims. They are very violent. And sweet war was going on. One third of India from Ganga to Godavari, up to that was ruled by Prataprudra Maharaju that time and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was residing in Puri. So he, when he was in Avadi, he sent to every house. Do you Kara Bala Krishna, Bhaja Krishna, Kara Krishna Sikhya. Speak Krishna. Do what Krishna taught, Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavata. What he taught. Kara Krishna Sikhya. Bhaja Krishna. Serve to Krishna. He did not say, Iha Bali Aravana Baliva Balaiva. Don't speak other things. Don't hear other things, and what the result comes, you come and tell me. Suna suna Nityananda suna Haridas. Amara ajnaya I karaha prakas. Prati hare ghare gya karai bhikya. Bala Krishna bhaja Krishna kara Krishna sikya. You go to every house and beg them. Not just then, don't go to teach them. Just go to beg them. But you will beg, you go, please give some alms, no? Begging. Begging is, in Vedic literature, Vedic system, begging is a highly respected Brahmins and sadhus and sannyasis who are higher society, they go to beg to alms for their maintenance. Highly respected this. So, Mahaprabhu, Lord Krishna also in Baman, he was Baman, he went to beg to Dhani Maharaj. So it was the system in our process also when we give initiation, we send them to beg. Begging means never steal, never speak lie. You go and beg, it is pure, it is nirguna, it is not contaminated. If we go to speak lie and cheat others, duplicacy, that is contaminated. So it was pure to beg. So Mahaprabhu himself, he was begging when he was sannyasi also. So he sent them to beg, but to beg, Bala Krishna, Bhaja Krishna, Kara Krishna Sikhya. Somebody come to give some grains, rice, some food, vegetable or something, no. They told, please tell Hare Krishna. Because they told that time nobody knows of Krishna, they forget that time. So, Bala Krishna, say Krishna. This is the beginning. How Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started his this mission, his preachings by begging. Bala Krishna, Bhaja Krishna, Kara Krishna Sikhya. This is the education, this is the knowledge, this is practice, this is our life to know Krishna. Who is Krishna? Bhagavad Gita, he told, Aṁ sarvasya prabhavo mataha sarvam pravartate iti matva abhujante maṁ buddha bhava samanmita. If somebody knows everything comes from me and everything is maintained by me, he is the Buddha, he is the wise, He knows everything. Nothing to else. This knowledge, what is knowledge? Knowledge means how everything with Krishna and everywhere Krishna is existing. This is the knowledge. That Maharaj told you about university. This university, about this knowledge, about this degree, PhD, doctorate, all these degrees. Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he told one verse. Jada vidya jata mayara vaibhava tumara bhajane badha jada visayate moho janmaya jivake karai gadha. He told this material knowledge. Iti mayara vaibhava. This vaibhava, this is the opulence of maya. Tumara bhajane badha. And one who got this degree and a certificate, a PhD, he became proud, he became arrogant, and his ego became increased, and he never surrender, never do bhajan to Krishna. Never he understands about his real character, real form. So he told, Tumara bhajane badha, jada visayate moho janmaya jivake karai gadha, and he become proud, arrogance and illusion, and he became like a donkey and only carrying this knowledge, this certificate, this position, degree, and always carry like a donkey in his head, nothing else. This is Bhaktivinoda Thakur true. He was highly educated in our sampradaya at that time. He has written many, many books in Seventh Gurusham. He has given us this. So nowadays, more degraded, because this technology science is nothing. Before was a literature, history, like that was different. Now the technology science is, we can make them like a part of machine. So they have nothing to knowledge, to realization, to understand, nothing. So now more degraded from Bhakti Vinod Thakur's time now. That time no computer, no this mobile phone, this internet, that time was not like that, now everywhere. So, knowledge is to see everywhere Krishna. This is the knowledge. We see Krishna's presence. Where is Krishna's presence? In plants, in any trees, any small creatures, insects, everywhere, any creatures, human, man, woman, animals, we see Krishna is present. He is the soul. Aham atma guda kesa sarva bhuta asaya sthita. He told, I am the atma, soul of every, I am their soul. So, how we can see these? Because our mind is always, by these three moods of nature, our mind, our consciousness is covered. We see other things. We see their external figure, feature. And when we see someone, immediately we affect our mind, affected by the, for example, we see some snake. We don't see Krishna is there. Immediately we fear. Oh, bring, there is a, we will die, this guy. We are affected by fear. If we see someone, we feel by lust. If we see something, enemy, someone, we hear something, we become affected by anger. Other thing is, in Bhagavatam, one verse told, who are qualified to understand in Bhagavata? Nirimba Charanam Satam. This jealous, Nirimba Charanam, malice, no? If we sit together, we stay in a temple also, if we are in a family, brothers, sisters, or we are in the temple also, if someone became more advanced, anyway, if some become advanced, do something, grow up, then others who are living there cannot at all. He became unhappy. Mind become unhappy. Oh, I cannot be like that. So then he started to envious. Even God brothers, God sisters, even enemies. This is one. This Nirmat Charanam Satam. This is from passionate knowledge, passionate these qualities. Guna Mursa of nature. It always contaminate our consciousness, our will and desire. So how to come out from that? This is the problem. This is the real education. How to free our consciousness? How to realize our original form, and then we will have realization to Krishna, and what we give to Krishna, Krishna will accept. Because Krishna told in Bhagavata Gita, who is most dear to me? In Bhakti Yoga, 12th chapter, he told, Avishtaha sarva bhutanam maitraha karuna evacha nirmamo nirahankara sama dukha sukha khyami santushtaha satatam yogi jatatma drudha nishchaya mayarpita manobuddhi jo madabhakta sa me priya. Who is most dear to me? He told, who are always satisfied, always happy, peaceful. Never his mind, his intelligence, never changed with this duality. What is duality? Somebody is enemy or friend. If friend, they have more attachment. For enemy, always they have bad feeling. Or Vishta, who has no enemy. If somebody is enemy to you, what will you do? No, you must be like a friend, and Karuna, you must be merciful to him, like father, mother to children. Maitra, Karuna, Yavacho, Nirmamo, Nirahankar, and you have nothing. I and my, this is ego, position and possessives. I and my, no, I and my, about the material existence. Sama dukha sukha khyami, sukha dukha, happiness and distress, it is the art of creation. Both are this, the duality there. So never fluctuate your realization, your mind. Sama dukha sukha khyami, santushta satatam yogi, always satisfied. Then you give some flower or fruit or water or anything. I am eating this. For example, we are servicing. We are offering Krishna some flower or bhoga. We are cooking and offering. Or we are making one garland. But our mind not satisfied, not happy. Maybe some envious there, some anger there. Something inside is burning. So when we take one flower, we put, oh, Krishna, please take care to him. He is doing this, that, please take. So our bhavana, our thinking, the energy, Krishna is antaryami, he is inside, he is super soul, he knows everything. So one flower is there, okay, Krishna, you will punish him. Another flower, you come, oh Krishna, you will be take care to him. You, Krishna, you will take care of me. I cannot be like this. So all garland is made by this kind of knowledge and conscious and feeling realizes. So Krishna never be happy. For example, in someone served to you, but he is not happy. He is not satisfied. If he is served to you, how you can be satisfied? Because who serves, he must be satisfied, then he can serve to other one. So if we are not satisfied, how we can say serve to Krishna? So Krishna told, you must satisfy first. So how you can satisfy? Because by this mood of nature, passionate nature, and ignorant nature, and goodness nature, three are not good. They are the covering to the soul, our consciousness. So who is free from this three mood of nature, they are liberated souls. So this is the education to understand how we realize ourself, also we give to distribute to others to realize them. There is no any problem. There is no any problem in this world. Krishna, we have to understand to Krishna. Krishna is the cause of all goddess. He is the supreme controller, supreme Godhead. Ishvara Paramaha Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Adi Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. He is the protector, he is the savior, he is our soul. If we realize this, and if we start relation with him, samandha jnana, we are always related to him. We never separate from him. We always related to him. Samandha jnana. Then avidheva, we can do some sadhana bhakti. Sadhana bhakti. And we will get the prayojana prema, the love to Krishna. We understand to Krishna, then we will realize and his divine, his pleasure potency, Radharani there, this both, the all creation come, they are the our father and mother, and so we realize to him and we teach to others. How we will teach? Not like a teacher, Mahaputra to beg, like a beggar. Please, you forget yourself, you realize yourself, you are a soul, you are not this body, you are not this hair, skin, flesh, blood, bone, you are soul, you are eternal, you are immortal, you are blissful. We have to distribute this knowledge to others with love, with respect, and begging. This is the mood of preaching. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told this. Then, sure success will come. Success will come. Even when Nityananda Prabhu, Haridas Thakur went to preach, Jagai Madhai, you know, also broke Nityananda Prabhu's head, blood came out. Still Nityananda Prabhu have no any feeling, no anything. He embraced him. Please tell Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. This is the Mahamantra, power of Mahamantra, Nityananda Prabhu applied to Madhai, who broke his head. And Madhai then started to vibrate. And he started to cry. And he fell down. All drunkard, they are robbers, dacoits, and all they are violent people. Rakshas like demons, no? But by Nityananda Prabhu's mercy, by the power of Harinama, he completely changed and got a prayer. You see, this is Mahaprabhu's message. So, the two power of the Harinama Krishna's name, power of Krishna's the knowledge. We have to realize everywhere Krishna's presence, knowledge. And our process is, bhakti is the surrender process. But whom we will surrender? we must believe him. He will take care to us. He will save to us. Then we can surrender. Among six parts of surrender, Anukulyasya Sankalpo, Pratikulyasya Varjanam, Rakshasatiti Vishwasu, Gotrupte Varanam Tatha, Atmanikhepa Karpunya, Saravida Saranagati. In the six type of this Saranagati, one is Rakshasatiti Vishwasu. Krishna will protect me. Krishna will save to me. Krishna will maintain to me. We must keep faith to him. Otherwise, how we can surrender to him? We can't. We can't surrender to him. We believe 100% believe. He will protect me. He will protect me. In Vrindavan, pastimes, Krishna's pastimes, when he was going to Vrindavan with all his cows and cowherd boys, one day they went to Kalya Hrada, where we see, no? So they went there, then they feel thirsty to drink water. Then they went to Yamuna, this pond, like Kalya Hrada, it was separated from the current of Yamuna. So they went there, and that was poisonous water. By Kalya poisoned his snakes. Many his family was there. So this was poisonous. Then this poisoned water, they told, how will we drink? In Bhagavatam has written, how we will drink? Then their friends told, we are thirsty, we will drink. If we will die, Krishna is there, he will again give us life. So they drank this water. And Krishna came after he saw they already dead. After drying this, then he again gave life to them. All they get life, then Krishna decided to remove this Kalya from here. And he jumped to this pond, then he kicked. The story is there, no? But the devotees, how? They believed Krishna. If they drink poisonous water also, they told Krishna will save us. They told this. What will they do? Krishna is with us. What can they do? They started to stop Indra's worship. Govardhana Puja started. All they sit there, then they decided, okay, we stop this now. We don't want to worship to Indra. Then they told Indra what they will do. Krishna will be there. Then next day, Indra started to pass punishment. They called to Krishna, please save us. Okay, Krishna saw his power. So with little finger he kept this Govardhana and all the saved and all the protected there. When they entered to Agha, this snake, Aghasura, demon Aghasura, when they are entering this Aghasura's mouth, they discuss, what is this? We never see like this in Vrindavan. You see, what is this? We can go inside, maybe something dangerous is there. Then others told, okay, if something there, Krishna is there. He will protect us. He will do this. You should go there. Then they enter in Kalya Aghasura's mouth. Then Krishna was in a big distance. He understood already they inside the poisonous gas. They already dead. Then Krishna understood, okay, now they, my devotees is after they die. So what shall I do? Already they are inside the womb. So he was waiting, Aghasura, Krishna will come, then he will close his mouth. And Krishna came. And the demigods, all the Brahmarshi, Devarshi, and all these demigods, they are looking at this, they became astonished, how Krishna is entering the Aghasura's mouth. They could not understand what to do. Then Krishna entered there inside, and in his neck he stopped and grow his body. Then the breathing air could not able to go inside and outside. His soul came out by his Brahmarandra. from his head come out. After Krishna when came out, then he, the soul from Maghasura entered to Krishna's body. They saw the demigods, Narada, Sanata, Sanandana, Sanat Kumar, Sanatana, Bhrugu, Angira, Vasishta, Paulaputta, they all they saw this, they became astonished. What is this first time Leela? This is demon who came to kill him. His soul entered to Krishna's body. Then they went to tell Brahma. Brahma told, what are which kind of pastime this demons he give place in his form inside his body. Then Brahma came to see and test how is this. Then started another Leela. Brahma had stolen all boys and calves. So Krishna in his pastimes he saw all these things. And when Kaliya, many sweet pastimes, we cannot, it is so sweet, we cannot imagine how is prema there, how is sweet there, love there with this. So we believe him that he is savior, he is protector, he knows everyone, what we are doing, what we are thinking, what we are, our future, our past, our present, he knows this. He told in Gita, Vedaham samatitani vartamanani charjuna bhavishyani cha bhutani mantu veda na kashchana. You don't know me, you don't understand me, but I know your past, your present, your future. He knows, he is super soul, he is the soul of everyone. If we understand to him and if we realize him, we surrender to him, we make his family. This universe is his family. Vasudeva Kutumbakam. His family this. Tameva Mata cha Pita Tameva. Tameva Vandhucha Sakhat Tameva. Tameva Vidya Dravinam Tameva. Tameva Natha Sarvamam Tameva. He is the father, he is mother. He is the protector. He is the friend. He is the our lover. He is the Kajapa. All causes. He told in Bhagavad Gita, Mata aham asya jagato, Pita aham asya jagato, Mata dhata pitamaha. I am your mother, I am the father, I am is your savior, I am the protector, he is the dad. So if we realize how he is working in this, how he is maintaining, how the plants come, how the insects come, how this tiger came, lion came by passionate nature, ignorance nature, this variety of creation, how it came developed. Bhagavatam has written this by these moods of nature, by the time, by the kala, how it is functioning, how we are there. So he has given this all memory to us, he has given such intelligence to human, he has given so much knowledge to us. If we cultivate, we realize to him, and this human body is such valuable for us. We can be with Krishna, we can friend with Krishna, we can serve to Krishna, we can be with Krishna and to get his him by this body. This is the importance of human body. Therefore, demigods also pray to get a human body. In Bhagavatam told, Svargenam apetam vichanti loko nirainam tatha jat jnana bhagya vairagya bhakti sadhakam. By this human, we can practice jnana knowledge, how Krishna is, everything is doing this, and vijnana, we can realize this, and vairagya, how we can detach from anything, we maintain free our consciousness, free our mind, free our intelligence, without to attach with anyone, without to attach with, entangle with anyone, we maintain our freeness and vairagya, then bhakti, how we can serve to the Supreme Lord with our prem, with our love, with our satisfaction, with our peace, with our happiness, with our love, we can serve to Krishna. This is the human life, we can do this that. So, many things to discuss and understand. Already you are joined with Guru Pada Padma and took initiation. Nobody you practice and start to understand and start to preach. Bharata Bhumite Hoiva Manushya Janma Jar, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, you practice, also you preach to others, give to others to realize. So their life becomes satisfied. They because they, if they know themselves, they know the Super Soul, Krishna, they don't want anything else. Because everything is there, Krishna is there, he protects this. So nowadays, in our education department, politics department and society, how they go modernize, they go to more far from our soul, they go more far from their own self, and they go to more and grossly enter to the material energy and they forget themselves, so it is actually loss. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and distributed to everyone, whole universe, they can have rights, they can to serve Krishna, to realize Krishna and to take care of their soul. This is not a simple religion, some principles, some culture, some society, some political, some vision or something doing, not like that. This is pure spiritual, pure love and real, absolute truth there. Paramasatya, satya is there, truth there, real blissful happiness is there, auspicious there, mind become peaceful and mind became cool. Brain became cool and peaceful and satisfaction, never harmed by any this passionate nature, ignorance nature, which is always harming and disturbing mind by lust, by anger, by envious, by this, that, many things they need, this suffering, many things become pure and peaceful. So their society they lead, human they lead, and by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, we have a lot of knowledge in the Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. This is one verse, it is sufficient to teach this whole universe. You practice them, not just speaking, you have to practice this to go to realize that is like an ocean. If they enter with one verse, they will attain in the ocean of Bhakti Rasa Amrita Sindhu, and they will success in their life. So by these 8 verses of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sikhyastaka, he has given all his philosophy, his practice, his instructions, everything is there. So we need to practice and we become a professor like realization, we realize and we give to realizations to others. This is the real, we need to universal preaching and university to understand this and to realize and practice. So our Maharaj, your Gurudev, you know, we have mostly trying to discuss many things about preaching, about practice, about anything. And it is also one thing I can tell you, difficult to understand by Indians' mentality, by their culture. If they don't come here, they cannot understand what is going on in this world. We are also saying, whenever we did not come out, we did not know what is happening, what is the world, this. It is completely different. Climate different, culture different, and many things different, our soul never different, all is same. But many things our practice like different there. But it is divinity there, and this is spirituality, how to practice and to come and to serve to Krishna. It is the most benefit in Kali Yuga, if we get this divine love to Krishna. Many things to decide. Anyway, I am fortunate to come today in the last moment and share with you. When yesterday I was coming with my Prachandra is coming, I saw this forest where we are going night time. So it is, Maharaj always like nature. He wants to stay with nature. He always hates this plastic and this, that. He doesn't want to like this, that. It's very, it is really sattva-guna, goodness. It will give us to realization and make purity. Practically he is doing something in Kumbh Mela. In India also many things involved with Yamuna, Bhargandavan protection, and he is planning many things to future, to engage to people, to how they practical, they can do something. They cannot sit, they cannot study, they cannot meditate. So they can engage for some service, they can do some, and come to Western associate. Is open, his heart is open. So now it is benefit for us, and we are together. And now many sannyasis also came before one, our big mission from Bhaktisiddhanta Swami Thakur. Is Sannyasi Maharaj came, and another Maharaj also, they are coming. So we will have nice Gaudiya Gosti, our society. So this preaching in our life, we will practice, we will preach, we have many friends, we have many opportunity to do something more, and our future generation, they will have also more to do this, that. We are like an instrument, but we can do little service. Maybe Krishna blessed us, Guru Varga blessed us, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu blessed us, we can do more service to them. I don't go to many time to take more. I think we have many things to do.
Can you tell us something, Maharaj, about Gurudeva Bhaktivaibhapuri Maharaj experience and your experience with preaching to the Adivasis in Orissa?
Yes, this is...
Adivasis are First Nation people of India.
They are. I was making one program when we have installation in Berhampur temple. Many devotees also came from many parts, like 50, they came. And near there, like 150 kilometers, 150 kilometers, they are all living there. And they don't want this modern facility. And they are living, they are satisfied with their nature. They are very strong, physically they are very strong, and they are living like same like old type. And Guru Maharaj always have compassion to them because they are innocent, simple person. Their brain is not contaminated. Intelligence is not contaminated like to, before we told, to exploit others, to slave others, to use them like mercilessly. So they become, those people, they simply surrender. Immediately they surrender. The intellectual people, now these modern people, they never surrender. They always thinking about, with intellectually, mentally, they always calculate this, they measure their knowledge. But that those people are very simple, they are, what they hear, they will follow, and they get benefit, like Krishna, he did his pastime in Vrindavan. They are not city people, they are village people and coward men, women, no? He played with them and he did not talk with Brahma also. Hey, Brahma came with the Sanskrit, he glorified him, he never see once to him, he never rejected him. In Vrindavan he saw how sweetness of their natural love. So he saw this. So this natural ancient tribe people, they say this tribe people, they are uneducated, but really they are uneducated. They are more grossly in Maya. They have faith, they have simple faith to Krishna. They believe the nature and they lead them. They never contaminate to others. If somebody comes, they give something. They are poor also, they give something, they help to others. So Guru Maharaj, we have many disciples there. There are 100 villages, every village they do kirtan.
Haribol.
They do nice kirtan. Together they do kirtan. And now I am constructing one temple also there. So we come. But what happened? Many from Christian institution, they give something them and they change their mind. They give some medicine or some cloth or something that they come back to them to believe to others, like something religious power. Fighting is going there. These simple people, they will come back to them like this. And maybe sometime I will take the Maharaj to see them when here to come to see how they live and how they don't use this fertilizer, chemical, this, that, they don't. Now government want to give electricity, this, that. Really they don't want, they are free and they live with nature, they do not need anything. They think, oh, we need this, this is not for them, this is not good, this, that, only useless things they are. But they are living peacefully, they are happy. So Guru Maharaj have this vision. He told they are simple person. They will immediately accept Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna and the Kirtan. And we should bring them, give them opportunity how they can practice this. So already we have some project going on to bring them Krishna consciousness. This modern education system, modern this fashion and this modern civilization, it is actually not good for soul, not good for this creation. Krishna also. Krishna's creation. Krishna's this property. Krishna's family. So Yanmadasya Jata, where from come the creation, come and he is maintaining. How they are creating this nuclear bomb, atom bomb, this, that. They think we are scientists, we are advanced, we are intelligent. What is for that? Only destroy the universe. So one thing is, in Sanskrit, one story was there we were reading, studying. Once three students, they went to study. So one went to study astrology, to know past, future, present. Another one, he went to study Ayurveda, about body and disease and Ayurveda. Another one went to study mantra, this sound, mantra study, science. So they went to three acharyas, three gurus. They studied 12 years, then again they came. And they sit one place, under one tree. They came together and they sit and discuss themselves. So, what you study? He told, I studied astrology. I know past, present, future, I can tell anything. Then another told, oh, what do you study? I know about the Ayurvedic, I know everything, what is your body, what happening, kapha, vata, pitta, three dosa, and all these I told. Another one, he told, I know all mantras, I can make anything. Then there was some bone was there. Then they asked, bone, skeleton.
Oh, skeleton,
bone. Then he asked to the astrologer, you know, what is this you can tell you by your astrology? He told, yes. Then immediately he sit and calculate this, that he told, it was a tiger. And all these village people, they kill and throw him here. This is his skeleton. Then they asked to the Ayurvedic, so he know about the body. He told, you know how you can make this tiger, how is this bone? He told, yes. Then he put all bones like tiger. And then they told to another one, you know mantra, you can give life? He gave, told, yes, I will give life. So he gave life. Now tiger became life. Then what after happened, they don't know. When tiger is alive, then he killed the 3 person.
This is
So this is the science. The science will kill them. So what is this useless? No? They don't know what is the ultimate result. They are not few, they have no future vision. If we see in Mahabharata, Mayadhanava, he has given this meeting house to Yudhishthira, where you cannot understand where is fire, where is water, where is green, where is what is. No one can understand. It's a divine, this was power. No? How he has constructed this that time. Then, when he gave, that was the number one in the earth planet. There was no like that anywhere. In Mahabharata discussed. Then Mayadhanava, he told to Arjuna, if you want, I can teach this technique, the science to you. Then Arjuna have interested to learn this. Krishna told, don't learn this. If you, this will not give benefit to anything in life, in society. This education, this science, this never give help to any benefit to human. So no need to learn this. So he did not learn this. So which knowledge, which will give to everyone to help to others, that is knowledge, to help others. Otherwise, knowledge will be misused to destroy themselves. So Guru Maharaj is always helpful and thinking about these ancient people, tribe people, they are innocent people, they believe. And we also, our practice, this we need simple life, plain life. Vaishnavism is simplicity. Vaishnavism is plain life. Speak same, think same, do same. Not think something, speak something, doing something. This is never give us advance in spiritual life or Vaishnavism services. Nowadays, morally they think something, they speak something, they do something, make the life very complicated. Anyway, they will suffer in old age. They will lose their memory, they suffer more because soul is there, Krishna is there. So they cannot make with intellectual something like that. So simple people, they are very clever to practice. When Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, he came to US, our Guru, to preach, to follow his Guru's order. He came there and no one that time heard to him, and he went to chanting Harinam Kirtan in the park. No? So, real educated who are, they came, who rejected the society, who rejected the family, who rejected the education, they are the real customer of this. All hippies, they rejected everything, no? But they became educated with the music. They know this philosophy. Yeah, this is too much illusion there. So this is, and they preach whole world, they preach it. We see this. So they are all avadutas, because they rejected everything. Real vairagis they are. So they, before taking this, some drugs, but they, when they take this Krishna's devotion and Maha Mantra, Harinama drugs, then they become ecstasy and chant, kirtan and dance. So, okay, Maharaj is doing many things. I do not, for our brain to understand, is also not easy. He has many plans doing this within India also, with go to a diplomat, meet with politicians, and to how to protect Vrindavan and keep Yamuna, and how to preach and bring together to all. Actually, he is doing a lot of things, and by your help and your service, he can do more things, and we will together. We are not actually, our brain is not able to do many things, but simply we do Harikatha and do something like that, why he is doing many things, and I appreciated him how he is doing these things, many things to do. Even he is not sleeping proper, not taking care, he always preaching, and it's less. Him and give more energy, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, to do service for our Western world. Okay, I am happy.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol. Sadhu, 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 Gaur, Abhimanandi, Hari Bol.